รายการต่อไปนี้เป็นรายการทั่วไปสามารถรับชมได้ทุกวัย
สวัสดีครับ
สวัสดีค่ะ Welcome to Talking Thailand I am Sueching Chin
I'm Daniel Whitehouse
I'm Plum Mom Luong Nattakorn Devakula Welcome to Talking Thailand another Saturday night right here on Voice TV we're happy to have all of you joining us today later on we're going to have a special guest the owner of Wellograph talking about his smartwatch
mm-hmm.
and we will also talk about the Apple Watch later on in the program คุณ Sueching คุณ Dan how are you doing
ดีค่ะสบายดี
สบายดีมากเลย
I'm doing great and I'm very happy that your country will see some sort of a separation
No
very happy
Don't say that it's not going to happen
This is one of the things we'll be talking about there's a referendum in Scotland
There is
to break away mm-hmm. you know how could you do it but break away into a separate country
I don't know
Scotland
อังกฤษกับสกอตแลนด์เลิกกัน
เลิกกันนะฮะ
scary will it happen
อยู่กันมา300กว่าปีนะฮะก็เดี๋ยวพูดถึงประเด็นนั้นแต่ว่าขอเริ่มด้วยเรื่องของอาหารไทยก่อน but I gotta start with this story about a guy named Andy Ricker
okay
because I've been quite obsessed with his success so far you know watching his rise to fame you know through coverage via a variety of media you know including CNN and the latest documentary produced by Vice NewsJust want to talk about this guy so that Thai viewers can understand that at this point, Thai cuisine, Thai food has made it so big mm-hmm. that one of the most well-known chefs, up-and-coming chefs in the United States now, has an Isan-themed restaurant serving gai yang, khao tam, khao niao, som tam.
Niao ด้วยเหรอ
Yeah,
oh, wow.
the whole Isan cuisine, and he serves it in the middle of New York.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is great. This is a guy by the name of Andy Ricker. And he seems like just an average, you know, quote unquote, Farang mm-hmm. or, you know, foreigner. This happens to be an American who traveled to Thailand and he fell in love with the cuisine. What's really interesting about this story is that this is not a trained chef. Mm. He's worked at a variety of restaurants before coming to Thailand. He took a trip to Thailand mm-hmm. just to travel and he started eating all these good.North and Northeastern Thai food, Isan foods. And he fell in love with the chicken, the beef salad, the som tam, khao niao, gang
pet. Who wouldn't fall in love with this type of food?
Yes.
I can't imagine.
What?
It's the best food.
That, you know. Okay.
Set ni da chong.
What is amazing about the story, as can be seen in the latest documentaries produced by Vice News about Andy Ricker, is that he went back to the United States, to his hometown of Portland, Oregon,and open a restaurant called Pok Pok, which is the sound of, you know, that noise you make with a som tam, Pok Pok, okay. So Pok Pok had this look in their menu and in the decor of the restaurant as a very Isan theme kind of deal. You go in, you feel like you're in Udon Thani, you feel like you're in Chiang Mai.
Wow.
And you can order soup na mai to nam phik num.
And this nam phik num.
Yeah. Now this, what is truly unique about Andy Ricker is that,This is not Gordon Ramsay traveling to Thailand learning how to do gra pao kai. This is not a trained chef, but he reverse engineer what he ate. Mm-hmm. So he ate nam phik num, for example.
Okay.
And then he started asking around, like, how did you make nam phik num or nam phik ong? So he goes back home, he finds all these ingredients, imports some of them, and he makes this stuff. He reverse engineers it. And then it became a huge success. And now,He's got a new restaurant, and it's I think it's called Pok Pok as well. It's right smack dab in the middle of New York City. So he's got two branches now. He's got one in Portland, one in New York City. And I just wanted to tell you this because in case you think that, you know, ahan ti go inter, you know, international food has to be French or Italian. Thai food can do the same, serving to the very highest...corridors of power
sure
you know in Hollywood to New York City
yes.
where mega lunches are held so
Well, this expand the variety of Thai cuisine. You know, before this, people only know Thai cuisine by specific dishes like pad Thai or tom yam goong. Maybe only these two dishes, right?
Yeah, that's gang kieu wan.
Gang kieu wan is always a bit of it. Yes. Yeah,
one of his mission is to do away with the myths about Thai cuisine that it has to be only pad Thai or spicy stuff or tom yam goong. And because of his success, and this is why I'm talking about this, because of his success, he's helped improve the reputation of Thai cuisine internationally. People do not think of Thai cuisine as just pad Thai or tom yum goong anymore, or not just, you know, chicken green curry. They now view Thai cuisine as being comprised of a variety of types of
more sophisticated than that.
So the international audience are introduced to all types of nam prik and all types of, you know, barbecue chicken, yum, you know, salad, you know, salad yum neua, yum goong.
I'm getting hungry.
Yeah, no, but,
no, but one of these days I had to travel to the United States to
just to go to Pok Pok restaurant.
Pok Pok, because I hear that he makes it better than even, you know, Thai chefs here in Thailand.
Really? It's amazing that, you know, by asking around of how to make Thai food, he could actually make a lot of, you know, menus, lots of dishes.
That's right, that's right. So he's got experts helping him as well. But like I said, he reverse engineered it,
and which is something not normally done by anyone.
You have to be gifted, talented.
Okay. He must be very talented. He must have a very good palate.
The only guy that would be better than him at this point in terms of a foreigner cooking Thai is David Thompson. And David Thompson cooks at Nam, which is a restaurant at Metropolitan Hotel in Bangkok.
I would love to go there.
I've never been. Okay, so I heard it's quite expensive.
It is expensive, but it is worth it.
Yeah.
So you got David Thompson, you got Andrew Ricker following right along up there.
But is Pok Pok, is this a sort of high
It's middle.
It's not middle upper. Not too expensive.
Yeah, not too expensive. It's middle upper. So highly recommended.
Let's go. Swing by Pok Pok.
Let's talk about the land where no Pok Pok exists.
No Pok Pok.
But
no.
Plenty of whiskey.
A lot of whiskey. Yeah, maybe they're all drunk. That's what the problem is.
Scotland.
So Scotland. So I'm going to talk about something. It is huge news in England at the minute. So what will happen is on Thursday, Scottish people will be able to vote, but they won't be voting for a political party or who will be prime minister. There will be a piece of paper with one question. And the question is, should Scotland be an independent country? Should Scotland be an independent country? And so they will vote if they want to split away from the UK.
This is Tuesday? Or is it,
this is Thursday.
Thursday, okay.
This is on this Thursday.
The vote is Thursday, and split away, meaning that right now it's part of the United Kingdom.
So right now it's part of the United Kingdom. So, Saharat Anadak.
Yes. Right?
So, yeah, so if they split away, then there will no longer be a United Kingdom.
Do the people of Scotland want independence?
Well, this is what's so interesting. This referendum has been planned for maybe 2 years now, and people weren't too worried. They thought, well, Scottish people and English people sometimes might talk, but we're friends, it'll be okay.
Yes.
But last week, there was a survey, and the survey found that more than 50% of Scottish people will vote yes. So it could be that England, Scotland, will be completely separate countries by next year.
They expect a high turnout. And normally when you have a high turnout, you got people who want to succeed coming out to vote more.
Sure.
And people who don't really care and like the status quo sort of just stays home and think that nothing will change. So there is that problem.
Yeah.
So that's why you have this late campaign now.
Yes.
By all of these former ministers, you know, including Gordon Brown.
Gordon Brown, the old prime minister.
Yeah, all these guys coming out to say that, oh, let's vote no.
Yes.
Let's stay a part of the United Kingdom.
Yes, and I'm going to add to that. Scotland, please vote no. We don't want you to leave.
Aww.
We still love you.
What
Scotland,
I don't get
come
is
back.
This. Scotland and England have been together since, what, 1700?
Beginning of 1700, yes.
So why now, after more than 300 years, do they wake up one day and want to succeed, separate?
And only in 2 years.
And only in 2 years. I don't know, it's strange. There have been previous referendums. So this is called a referendum. ประชามตินะครับ so a referendum when you vote for a particular policy there have been referendums before but people have always voted no but this time it seems like more people will be voting yes
will life change though because I don't sense that nothing will change
I think some things will change the strange thing is we don't really know what will happen. It's very strange. Will Scotland still use a pound? Maybe the Prime Minister will say, no, you're not allowed to use a pound. Will they be part of Schengen visa? Mm. Will they have the euro? Will they have their own army? But the thing that's really...
If you're an independent country,
you can
do all of that.
You can do whatever you like.
Well, at this point, you don't have a Prime Minister of Scotland.
No, we have a minister of Scotland, but not a prime minister.
If it succeeds, you could have a prime president of Scotland.
Or a president. Not a president, because actually Scottish people have already said they want to keep the Queen. So they will still be ruled by... So a bit like Canada.
What's the point? If you're going to separate from the United Kingdom, you're going to be part of the kingdom still.
You'll be part of the kingdom... In terms of the king and queen, but not in terms of politics.
Okay.
So the politics will be separate. But something that's really interesting and that is a big thing that will change is that at the minute, if you look behind, the Union Jack, the flag of Britain, it will have to change.
Okay, what is this flag then?
This, I'm not sure what this is.
This is taking things apart and trying to reassemble the Union Jack.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we'll show you the Union Jack thing on the screen, but Union Jack is the regular flag now.
So Union Jack is a regular flag of the United Kingdom, and it's... Actually, it's a flag of the United Kingdom. Wales, Scotland, England, Northern Ireland. There are only three countries. So we have the blue... And the white, this represents Scotland. And then the red cross is England. And then we have the red diagonal cross.
Yes.
And this is Northern Ireland.
So Wales didn't even make it to the
Union Jack.
So you have to change the Union Jack flag.
So we'll need to change it. So there's been some designers who have come up with some new designs for the Union Jack. It's quite exciting, yeah. Some are good, some not so good. So perhaps we can have a look at what some people have suggested could be the next flag of the United Kingdom.
Okay, so this is
you have to take away the blue part, right?
Oh, we've not got any.
We have to use your imagination.
Well, one suggestion is we just take away the blue, so then we'd have a red cross, and then behind a red cross like this.
That's not going to be as pretty as the Union Jack.
It's not as pretty. It's a bit boring.
I find it ironic that you can treat this subject so lightly.
Oh.
This is no.
Well, it hasn't happened yet. It hasn't
because
happened
this
yet.
Is a big deal. I mean, you're separating a big chunk of land from a country, and that new country can basically do anything. It can have an army.
It could have an
army. And declare war against England like 300, 400
years ago. They would lose.
They already lost. But they already lost. That's why they're part of the kingdom.
I don't get this
because Scotland is part of the UK.
Yes.
But it's not like it's a colony. I mean, it's not like it's being subjugated under slavery.
No.
It's not, you know what I'm saying? It does not have the same reason to succeed like, other impoverished pockets of the world where they are ruled by force, by an autocrat,
Yeah. In fact, I hope there's not many Scottish people watching, but... You never know. I'm sorry.
They might declare war on you here.
A lot more taxes go back into Scotland that come out. So, in fact, some people say if Scotland votes yes and they become separate, they will have less money than they do now.
Oh, okay.
It actually economically is not going to be a good decision. But there's a lot of nationalism. Scott people are very proud. There's a big campaign with actors, ministers saying, yes, let's be our own country, let's try and do this.
Now, of course, when Thai people, for the most part, when they travel to the UK, they feel it's all the same. In Wales, in Northern Ireland, in Scotland, we feel it's all part of the same country. But
I guess it's the way you guys look at Southeast Asia sometimes.
Yes, exactly.
Laos and all the same. Myanmar and Thailand.
Well, actually, I think for people outside of Britain, it's sort of confusing because you have these four countries, but they're all kind of one country, but they're sort of not. They're kind of countries in countries. And it can be kind of confusing for English people as well. You know, sometimes if I'm filling in a form on the computer and I click, am I English? Am I UK? Am I British?
Yeah,
it's very confusing sometimes.
Yeah.
I can see why
it would be confusing. Also, apart from the flag, there is one good question. What would it be called after the separation?
Yeah, who knows?
It can't be United Kingdom anymore, right?
No, it would be Greater Britain, maybe?
No,
Greater England. Greater England, maybe.
No, it's less great.
Less great. Not so great
it's
England.
It's smaller.
It'd be smaller. It'd be a lot smaller. Yeah.
The former United Kingdom.
The former United Kingdom. Kingdom is another one. Do we are at my Motsomtowline?
Yes.
Former United Kingdom. Okay. That could be a possible name.
But still,
it could be.
Great, Great Britain. Okay.
I hope so.
All right. Yopakkan Sakru Nakap. We'll be right back with more of Talking Thailand.
Welcome back to Talking Thailand. So now, talking about symbols and flags, I want to show you my family crest.
Oh, okay. I'm so jealous of you.
What is this crest?
A crest คือสัญลักษณ์ตระกูลของครอบครัวแดเนียลนะครับคือ the White House family crest.
มีด้วยเหรอฮะ
มีด้วยนะครับ
okay.
เป็นตระกูลดังๆด้วยนะคร
ับ ไม่เท่ากันนะครับตอนแรกนะครับ
We could make you one afterwards We could do that for you
This is it
This is my family crest No this is my family crest So my family came over to England about 1,000 years ago with the French ก็คุณเดิมเป็นคุณฝรั่งเศส
Yes
in 1066 and we brought our family crest with us.
Would this is the case for all families in the UK?
If a family ถ้าเป็นคนอังกฤษ 100% นะครับแล้วก็เป็นครอบครัวเก่านะครับ If it's an old เป็นตระกูลนะครับ Yeah they should have
so
a family crest.
You come from heritage.
Not,
you're not royalty, but
I'm not royalty.
You come from heritage.
So they were Asawin, nah, so they were knights.
Knights.
K, my K N, been Knight.
Daniel Whitehouse. Now this side.
I should get one of those big swords, ride a horse.
Yes, you should, you should.
This crest is as old as, like, you know, 1,000 years.
So this is about 1,000 years old, this crest. But what happens is, with a family crest, when your family wins a battle, or they do something particularly good, or sometimes something bad, they add things to the crest. So you can see my family crest has two dogs, and both of the dogs have one leg lifted like this. So this means we were successful in a big battle. If you have two, that means you were successful twice. So we had two successful battles.
What about if you're like successful for four times? Then you just like be flying.
I think they add another animal. So then we would maybe have three dogs.
Okay.
Maybe, I'm not sure.
This was passed down all the way to the current generation.
Yes. Yeah. To my family.
I'm surprised.
Yeah. So I just thought I would talk about this to show you that symbols in England, like the Union Jack, can be very important, and people feel quite strongly about them.
I'm just surprised how long it has been since the original White House came over from France.
I mean,
this was passed down for generations. This is amazing.
Yeah. It is amazing.
And when I say Namsakun Ku White House, คนไทยบอกว่าทีนี้ขาวใช่ไหมครับ They think I'm named after the White House.
Oh, they think that you're related to Amy Winehouse.
Oh, Amy Winehouse.
แต่นี่เก่ากว่าเยอะเลย
เก่ากว่าเยอะ
ใช่ใช
่ So he does have a traditional
heritage. So moving from the old days to the present, it's actually recently happened after much speculation, rumors, and a lot of guessworks. We now know the look, you know, and the spec and the tech spec of the new iPhones, two models of iPhone 6. So they are called iPhone 6 and iPhone 6 Plus. We talk about the rumors, how they might come true, and this is exactly what we saw in the leaked, many leaked pictures. iPhone 6 and iPhone 6 Plus look exactly like that. So there are two sizes of screens, 4.7 and 5.5. I don't know if you can imagine how big a 5.5 inch
big,
screen
right.
actually is.
It's among the biggest in the market then.
Yes, exactly like Note 2 from Samsung, you know, Note 3 would be like 5.7 if I'm not mistaken. So it's very big actually. And I kind of feel bad for Steve Jobs, you know, he would always insist that iPhone stay the same with 4-inch screen. But now Tim Cook just took it to the next level, making it a lot bigger, you know.
Although there is still the option of the smaller screen. There will be a model with the 4-inch.
4.7, right? Yes, exactly.
But the, is 4.7 is the smaller screen, or is there the old version?
The old version, which is iPhone 5S, would be 4-inch screen.
Okay, so the new ones will be all at least...
A little bit bigger, if you can see now.
Okay, so people who want the smaller version can still buy the iPhone 5, I guess.
Exactly.
So
iPhone
that's a consolation 5S,
5C, and iPhone 5 will still be in the market. But if you want newer models, you have to spring for iPhone 6 and iPhone 6 Plus. Mm-hmm.
This is really an answer to LG and Samsung, who have been making all these large screen phones.
Sunscreens are very big.
So I do understand why Apple is doing this. It sort of has to, because the consumers are demanding the bigger screen.
Right, and I agree, because after I switched to this Google Nexus 5 and the screen is 4.9, closely to 5, I'm so used to bigger screen that I can't really go back to
when
iPhone anymore.
When you go back,
anymore.
It seems so small.
It's so,
right?
When I do that.
Very easily. Okay, so I was excited about the iPhone. Mm-hmm. But I was much, much more excited over the Apple Watch.
I know.
Because the Apple Watch was an entirely new product set from Apple. And they call this the wearable technologies, meaning that they could have other devices coming our way in the future. Now, the iPhone really is an improvement on
size.
They're
okay. Yeah, okay. Yes.
But let's look at the Apple Watch, shall we? Because the Apple Watch is really something brand new. It's...
And it's a lot more beautiful than we imagined it would be.
It's gorgeous because it's got sapphire glass coating on the outside, so it's very
luxurious.
It shines in a way. And you know the curves? Look at the curves.
Yeah, I mean it's so smooth.
I know.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah. I didn't expect Apple to make a watch this beautiful. And this looks like a watch that would be pretty expensive. I hear it's going to be priced at around...
Starting from $349.
So that's about 1,200 baht at least for the cheapest model.
Yeah.
But you know, Kun Sueching, I think it's going to be success. Look at all of the varieties. Daniel, you don't have to buy just one type. There's like all types of watches. And then you can change the bands. You can get leather straps, you can get aluminum alloy,
stainless steel. And you can change the design of the watch face so that it feels like you have a new watch every day,
you know?
Oh, wow.
So, and then there's also the gold-plated 18-karat gold versions.
I would love to have that one. Well, the main the thing that Apple is very proud of, as you can see in this picture, it's called a digital crown. So it's kind of like a new way to control your watch. Instead of like the gesture of pinch and zoom, which Apple seem to think that if you with screen this small, if you use your fingers to pinch and zoom, then it will just block your view. You know, you can't really see any information on the screen. So they came up with the idea of having this digital crown, or in Thai would be called Met Mayom. Some people say it should be Met Apple, you know. But supposed to be a new way to control the watch. People are, you know, they're torn whether it's good or it's bad, but just think about the iPod. When it first came out and it has a click wheel, people were so excited about it, and it was something of a, you know, innovation. So this could be something like that, like innovation, but you're going to have to try first and see if it's easy to use.
But don't you love the miniature apps, though? That's cute.
Yeah.
They're very cute.
That's cute.
That's very nice.
Because what this watch has going for it is cuteness of the screen.
Very cute.
You know, compared to luxury watches out there like Rolex and Patek Philippe, it's all cool.
But they're not fun.
But they're not fun.
Exactly.
This is fun. And it's also not cheap. So you don't look cheap wearing a watch like this.
No.
You look like, okay, you got some money.
Yeah. Yes, it's and you're cool. not forced to just wear one style
yeah,
of watch.
Yeah, you can customize
for,
it.
Yeah, for those other
so
brands,
much more popular.
Maybe they don't suit you. But for this, you can actually pick which one would be the best style or design for you.
The best feature, from what I heard, is how the watch can record your heartbeat.
That's the best feature that you like, Kunplum?
Yes, and then you can send over the recording of your heartbeat over to another person wearing the watch. You know, let's say if you want to start flirting with someone.
Yes.
You send them your heartbeat. And they get it right away. Like,
yes.
It shows the heart pumping.
Okay. And you could say something like, when I see you, my heart skips a beat. And then you
and then you prove it by sending the
That's just one of the cute features. But I think this is a groundbreaking moment for Apple if they have other wearable technologies in the future to combine with this. So this has to be only a beginning.
Yeah.
This cannot be just it. You know, it has to be the beginning of more of wearables.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, I think so.
But impressive, certainly. Many experts were saying that that was an iPad moment. That was a moment.
Yeah, in 2010.
This is a big moment for
You think this is going to be as successful as the iPad?
I do have a sense that they will be able to get customers to skip over from the luxury watch market, a portion of them, to buy this watch.
Especially like having this Apple Pay feature.
Yeah.
You can actually pay for your products, your service that you purchase by using an iPhone 6, iPhone 6 Plus, and maybe your Apple Watch.
Maybe the watch as well.
Yeah, so you don't have to carry around your wallet, your credit card. Tim Cook said that it's, you know, very frustrating when you have to pay and then you have to like kind of fish for your wallet in your purse and take out the credit card, which, you know, is plastic.
That's right, that's right.
It's not durable.
Okay. Wearable technologies is very convenient as well. Let me mention just briefly the new service by Delta Airlines. Because apparently now if you have a smartphone, or maybe if you have a smart watch like this, now they will start accepting scans of QR codes of your boarding pass. Now, previously, of course, we already have check-ins. You can book your flights online. You can check in online, right? When you get to the airport, at the end of the day, you normally need a boarding pass to carry on hand. But what Delta Airline has done is to make a guarantee now that you don't need a boarding pass to carry. And you can have a QR code that is sent over to you after the online check-in process. And you can show that QR code on your mobile device as you walk into the gates, and that is enough to allow you to enter the airplane. They have promised this for all their flights. This is among the few airlines that have done this. So now you can have the experience of flying all the way from beginning to the end with just wearing a watch or carrying a phone.
That is cool. So good. There won't be any problem of like losing your boarding pass anymore because you have it with you all the time, especially on your watch.
Okay, so you better charge your batteries.
Yes.
Yes.
That's the only thing that could go wrong.
Or have a backup battery. Have a lot of backup batteries with you.
So, okay, so that's Delta Airlines. Okay, next break, we got a very important guest. He's gonna be showing us also another smart watch owned and produced by Thai people. But it's going to hit the shelves of the U.S. markets. The owner of Wellograph, coming up next. Welcome back to Talking Thailand.
Thailand from the inside out and outside in.
รูปมองประเทศไทยในมุมมองที่แตกต่างระดับโลกกับพวกเรานะครับ
มีอีกท่านหนึ่งนะครับนั่งอยู่ในบนโซฟากับเรานะครับท่านเป็นแขกรับเชิญในวันนี้เป็นเจ้าของครับเป็น CEO ของ Wellograph. Wellograph is smart watch. A new smart watch that you will like, I think. We have the owner with us.คุณอาร์ตคุณสารสินบุพพานนท์สวัสดีครับค
ุ
ณอาร์ตครับ
สวัสดีครับ
great to have you on the show just after the introduction of Apple Watch that we just talked about in the previous segment we got our own very smart Thai inventor and, mm. and businessman who brought with him here tonight to Voice TV, the Wellograph. Now, Khun Art, I got to ask Khun Sueching. Khun Sueching first introduced me to this watch,
mm-hmm.
and it looks good.
It looks really good. The first time I saw it, I felt like this is a fashion item, you know, which was different from the other smartwatches out there that sometimes it would be awkward for women like me to be wearing. But for this one, would you look at the design?
Yeah, let's have a look at this. Khun Art Khap, maybe you can help describe what's going on there in the shot right there. It's a beautiful looking one.
Yes, it is a watch that suits designed to suit any occasion. You can suit it up or denim it down.
Mm.
So we make it not for fitness minded people, but also fashion minded users.
Is that a leather strap? It looks like leather.
Yes, it's a real calf leather.
Calf leather.
Oh wow!
And the screen in front is kind of cool.
E-paper.
What is it made out of?
It's a ultra low power display
uh-huh.
that is always on, so it doesn't consume too much battery, and you can run it for 7 days.
Okay, 7 days.
Wow.
Okay, and then you recharge. What is this watch used for? If one were to wear a Wellograph,
mm-hmm.
you know, looking at the screen right there, I mean, if you push the buttons, what do you actually see, you know, showing up?
It will show you the what we call the activity tracking mode. We show you the day summary, the week summaries,
mm-hmm.
and how you burn calories per day, as well as how long you've been idle.
Mm.
Mm. Which is not good, you know. Sitting too much can really kill you.
So it, no, it,
there's
it,
a research
it, it tracks
on that.
Your activity. This is what the Wellograph does.
Yes.
I mean, how much? And what kind of software do you put in there? Because I understand Wellograph is a watch brand, it's a watch company.
Yes.
But how did you integrate the software into the technology into it?
The key point, the key component of this watch is a heart rate monitor.
Mm-hmm.
This is
mm-hmm.
the most important sensors that will be, that in the future we will see integrated in every wearable.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Because it give you the most important bio information about our health.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So we start from that sensor. We've been working so hard on this core technology for 3 years,
mm-hmm.
and we put it and integrate into a nice classical minimal design.
So it measures your heart rate.
Yes.
By you know listening to the pulse on your wrist.
Yeah, you can see the green lights mm-hmm. right here.
Wow.
So it kind of like monitors your heart rate all the
cool.
time.
But, you know, Dad, you've seen these types of watches before, though, haven't you? I mean, other brands have them out there, like LG and Samsung. I mean, how does this look to you?
I think it looks good. As Sueching was saying, I like this design
mm-hmm.
more than the LG, any of the other similar watches I've seen. I think this is a really cool design.
Mm.
I would wear it. I would definitely
wear it. This feels like a luxury watch to me.
It looks like a luxury watch.
Yeah.
Was
it supposed to be a luxury watch, or is it really intended for all of these, you know, social activities? I mean, what is it really aiming for?
It's supposed to be a luxury flash premium watch
mm.
mm-hmm.
mm, designed for the audience who care about their health.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
What? Mm-hmm. How did you get started into this? You're a Thai person, been Khun Thai, and it's just like, you know, all of us, including Khun,
yeah.
Khun Dan.
But Chalao.
What happened to you to get, I mean, really, what happened to you to get involved mm. in this?
Yeah, you would imagine that only people in Silicon Valley
yeah.
could pull something like this off, you know?
Yeah.
Like, Thai
you're
people
not,
may not be as good.
You're
enough.
Not Mark Zuckerberg. I mean, why? What are you? And you're not, you know, Steve Jobs
course,
or Tim Cook.
Course.
What are you doing inventing something like this? How did you come up with this idea?
We've been in technology business for almost 10 years. But we've been working, offering products in different industries. It's called book scanners.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it's quite popular, and it becomes the industry standard for how libraries around the world digitize their millions of their books.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you say you design, your company designed those products.
We made and sell book scanners for libraries around the world.
Wow.
Did you hear Google's effort to try to digitize all the books in every famous library in the world so that people can get access to all of those books? So his company was kind of like behind the technology, the similar technology.
So this is sort of the untold success story of a Thai entrepreneur in a way.
That's amazing.
That's cool.
That's really cool.
That's a congratulations. The Thai nation proud. So, okay, your company was involved in creating those technologies.
Yes.
And then this is basically kind of an offshoot of more products.
The new one, from the team. The book scanners are nice, but we cannot use in our home. We cannot see our dad use it. So we were thinking of how about let's make some products so that we can use and proudly use, you know, proudly wear one. And also let our parents wear one at home. So what is the best product if it isn't available? So 3 years ago we starting our work on this.
Is this something that you think you have to be seriously involved and try to compete against other watchmakers? I mean, this is not an easy business. You're competing against big companies. You know, if you want to do a smart watch, you got Apple as a competitor in the United States, which is where you're selling this stuff, right?
Yes.
You got LG, Samsung competing against you. These are huge conglomerates. How do you plan to tap the U.S. market?
We have investors. We also we are privately funded. We have some capitals from our first successful company that is still operating profitably. So we have some good resource, but of course. We are David versus Goliath.
Right.
So at any point in time, there will be companies that have thousands of million times of resources. So small companies sometimes they can execute well, you know, and they become, you know, successful product company later on. So
the biggest market will be the United States for you, right?
Yes.
What about in Thailand? Is this being sold in Thailand as well?
We are talking with some partners, and you will see them available offer in, you know, stores and well recognized stores. But for the U.S. now, we have a good partnership deal with Microsoft. So you will see Wellograph available at every Microsoft store in the U.S.
Okay, who, that's going to be some good sales.
Hundreds. Who came up with
amazing.
That? With
hundreds
that name.
Of, that, yeah.
That's a very cool name, Wellograph.
Wellograph.
So it's kind of like a new invented word, right? Wellograph.
What does it mean for you? I mean,
it's the graph of wellness.
I think
because
that's a
all
good idea.
Show as a graph.
Because you don't want to emphasize just it's just for people interested in sport, right? It could be for, like you said, for your grandparents, they're worried about their health, they want to know what their heart's doing. Young people, it could be for everyone who's interested in their health.
Okay, now you have convinced me now. I have to go on now.
Do you know what one thing worth noting is that I had a talk to Kun Ad before interviewing for the Cool Tech Show, and he did mention that Wellograph can really show notifications just like all the smart watches. You know, when you asked me, Kun Bloom, the other day, why am I wearing a smart watch? And I said, because I can take a look at notifications from my phone. So Wellograph decided not to do that. And there's a concept, a thinking behind this.
So there's not all these beeps and sounds that annoys you?
No. It's not our focus. Not to say that we're not saying that notifications aren't good. They are really useful. But for us, we want to focus on style and health. Offer the best health watch in the market, in the world. And I think if we focus on that, we will do well enough.
I'm very proud, to be honest. This is a man who's doing stuff. He's aiming to be, you know, at an international, you know, world level. This is truly going in the, you know. And look at this. This is tough, man. Oh, hey, tough, man. This is calf skin. This is
sapphire, crystal.
Okay, forget the Apple Watch. I don't need that. This is owned by a Thai person. I'm very proud. Where do you manufacture this?
The product is manufactured, assembled in Vietnam.
In Vietnam, okay. You sound like some, you know, big multinational businessman, you know, who's got a product manufacturing in Vietnam, you export to the United States, but you're homegrown, you're from Thailand.
Yes.
Okay, so you're aiming big. I mean, how many are we going to be seeing this in the U.S.? Like, how many sold? What is your target, if you can tell us?
in a year.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
In a year, we hope to sell around 100,000 pieces.
Wow.
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 Mm-hmm.
อันนี้ของจริงนะครับคุณซูชิงอันนี้ของจริงนะผมประทับใจมาก
จริงๆเคย
The projected market size for variables for this year is 17 million
okay
pieces so if we do to achieve 1% of the market we would need to sell 170,000So we're not aiming that big.
Not quite. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Not quite.
Just under 1%.
How do you create a trend? Because one of the key points to success in this industry is that you have to have word of mouth. Mm. You know, for example, Apple. You know, when they launch a product, people are talking about it. So people go crazy and go out and buy it. Mm. How do you create word of mouth in a big market like the United States? I mean, is it possible?
It is. It is. We working with. A PR company there to help you know publicize our products. Mm. Currently, our products you will see a lot more publicity and articles about Wellograph very soon because currently we are sending dozens of these units to big name media
and
publications.
Yes.
You know,
all
the blogs, all the advertisements coming out.
All those blogs and the famous tech, you know. Columnist. Mm-hmm.
So you're going to get really famous soon, right? It's a good job we got you now. You're going to be a busy man in a few months.
That's not our goal. Our goal is about the product. Yeah.
Okay, now you're going to be invading the markets in the United Kingdom very soon.
That's yes, also you can hire Dan
Europe?
As a presenter.
I could be your good hand.
Okay, how old do you have to be to wear this kind of watch, Wellograph?
I think people from late 20s, you know, up to senior people can wear this quite, you know.
So all people will not find it difficult to use?
Actually, one of the tester is my dad.
Oh, okay. he likes the two buttons thing.
It's not really that hard to operate.
He doesn't really like it. He complained a lot and gave me a long list of suggestions of improvements.
Oh, really? Did you follow them?
No.
Oh, okay.
Are you going to have a gold-plated version? You know, everyone is asking for 18-karat gold. Is that necessary?
Just like
not really,
watch.
But people we want different materials and colors options, and we plan to offer. In a variety of color choices like copper, rose gold, something like that.
Oh,
do you
rose
plan
gold
to make it round?
Nice.
หน้าจอตอนนี้มันกำลังเป็นเทรนด์ที่แบบเปลี่ยนจากสี่เหลี่ยมมาเป็นวงกลมอะค่ะ So do you have any plans to kind of like change the shape of the screen?
We were thinking about that from the start, but we kind of had some reservation because much of the information is best displayed in you know.
Yes.
A square format. Mm. The only thing that is best displayed as a circle is, you know, a clock, an analog clock. But other than that, you know, it's best displayed as a square display. Mm. Or else it would like you know, fitting a square in a round hole.
Mm. You believe that this is really the technology of the future? This will make lives more convenient.
I believe yes, it is, and there is no it's inevitable. The variables is the next trend.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
What about the sleep patterns? Because you know a lot of watches can not only can tell how many steps you take a day or how many calories you burn, but it can also tell the patterns of you know your sleep every night. Do you plan to do something like this? Put it in the watch sometime
yes,
in the future?
Yes, many customers are requesting that features. Actually, it's quite easy to implement that. You just need to use motion sensor to detect our movement and some heart rate. When we sleep, the heart rate gonna go down a little bit. That's all. So it's quite easy. Mm-hmm. What's more interesting is we can do and can track a lot more than sleep tracking and activity tracking. Some of the researchers, the libraries that we're working with, not the libraries, I mean universities that we're working with, they're gonna take it to the next level, detecting your stress.
Oh wow!
Detecting the condition of your body inside.
Oh.
So I mean,
how do you detect stress? What is that through the heart pulse or is
yes,
that something
by else? Detecting the heart at very very high frequency.
Ah, okay.
We can see the you know the the nature inside.
Oh, so if you are told that you are stressed right now, maybe you can do something to change it. You know, you don't let it go on for like hours, but you can just, you know, make yourself feel better, happier.
Yeah.
I like that.
How big of a company is this going to be? What is your aim for Wellograph?
We don't really aim, you know, that's not our focus. Our focus is that we want to sell to meet a certain target so that it's profitable. Mm. And then we will work on the next product.
And this team of engineers and software and developers, are they Thai or are they, you know, from all places, all countries?
Actually, they are all Thai.
Really? Wow.
Including the designer, who is a Thai, who is a famous designer coming back from San Francisco, but he is now here in Thailand.
Wow.
So you see the product here, it says design in Bangkok.
Wow, okay.
Made in Vietnam.
Thailand.
So very proud of
Thailand. ถ้าอย่างนั้นจะต้องย้ายไป Silicon Valley ในอนาคตไหมคะ
Maybe we are the potential new Silicon Valley of Southeast Asia.
That would be great.
by the way, I've been told that you got a gift today.
Oh,
really?
What? Yes. He's got
no.
Yeah.
So we have one special gift. This is the brand new unit, hot off the press.
Wow.
That took hand carry from the factory. So
oh wow.
Here's one unit for Talking Thailand.
We are allowing Dan to have this one.
I feel so proud. I will put it on now.
We are going to have to share, Dan.
Sueching has many watches already.
Oh, really?
From her trips over to San Francisco and Google headquarters.
She can have weekends. I'll wear it in the week.
Yes, you will enjoy it.
ขอบคุณมากนะครับ
ขอบคุณมากนะครับ
ไม่ถึงว่าภูมิใจนะ as a Thai person I'm proud that this watch is produced by a company owned and really operated by Thai people who can produce something at this level
and also receive an international award from the CES this year
okay.
which is something very big
นะครับก็คุณอาร์ตนะครับขอบคุณมากที่มานะครับแล้วก็ขอให้โชคดีนะครับในตลาดในสหรัฐซึ่งคู่แข่งเยอะนะฮะแล้วก็ไม่ธรรมดาทั้งนั้นนะครับคุณอาร์ตนะครับคุณสารสินบุพพานนท์นะครับ
ขอบคุณมากครับ
ขอบคุณ
มากครับ
สวัสดีครับ
We'll take a short break. We'll come back with more of Talking Thailand.
Welcome back to Talking Thailand. So we have learned a lot of new English vocab words, and we have four that we would like to go over again.
We got customized, like the watches of Apple.You can customize แปลว่าปรับให้เข้ากับแบบที่คุณต้องการ
ใช่ค่ะ
ประมาณน
ั้
น
ใช่ไหมวิญญาณ How do you use this in a sentence
ก็เหมือนกันนะครับคือ let's say for example I saw Sueching wearing a watch that she has changed the style she's changed the color she's changed the face I'd say oh wow Sueching I really like how you've customized your watch
ทำให้เฉพาะแบบที่คุณต้องการ
ก็จะไม่เหมือนใครด้วยใช่ไหมคะ
Customize your watch okay and speaking of this I was using this term called reverse engineering นะ reverse engineering คือ engineering ก็คือวิศวกรรมศาสตร์เนี่ยนะแต่ว่าการทำ reverse engineer คือทำคุณลองบางสิ่งบางอย่างใช่ไหม you look at something and then you figure out how to make something in reverse so you don't actually learn and make it in the way that you're supposed to be learning it
so you see the end result first
yeah you see the end result
first and then you go
back and then you go back ก็เห็นผลเห็นผลลัพธ์ก่อนแล้วก็หาแนวทางในการสร้างสิ่งนั้นย้อนหลังนะครับนั่นคือ reverse engineer so people who are good with you know making knockoffs
yeah
making copies you know youthen they will probably do reverse engineering.
Well, that's what rival technology companies do. Yeah. So Apple today have released their...
Take things apart and see.
Samsung will be taking them apart.
No,
we can't say that.
Someone will be taking them apart.
I got my Samsung around here. Okay, I still use the Samsung. Okay, and then we also have the term palette, P-A-L-A-T-E, which is the receiver of like taste. What do you call this?
ตอมร
ับ
รส
ใช่ actually the word is French it comes from when painters it's called a palette so when someone paints they'll have on a wooden board red yellow blue and then they mix on the palette
but then ทาสี
แต่ but then we nowadays we can use it also for your tongue So you receive different tastes, and if you can say, oh, that is carrot, that is coriander, we say you have a good palate. You can receive
taste very well.
And another useful term is something that you introduced to us from your family, the crest. It's been Sanyalak Pracham Trakun, which I had no idea that Daniel Whitehouse has a family heritage dating back to the days when the French immigrated to England.
But they didn't immigrate, they invaded.
That's very cool.
It's cool.
Did you guys beat out the British?
Well,
and the Scottish?
We sort of did, yeah.
But the Scottish, did they help?
No. Well, what happened was the king then. Do you watch Game of Thrones?
I watch Braveheart.
Oh, okay. Well, in Game of Thrones, they build a big wall to separate the north. That happened in England.
Okay.
So that king who invaded built a huge wall called Hadrian's Wall. You can go there now, but now it's very small. It was very, very high before. And that was to keep out the Scottish people.
Oh, okay. So
a thousand years ago.
Long history of animosity leading to the referendum coming up this next Thursday.
Yes.
So we'll see what happened then. Why is this so slighted, like slanted like that?
This is the style. This is a cool... This is the cool style of my mom today.
Okay, hold it like that. Okay.
Yeah.
So did you buy this?
Actually, this was a gift to me from a student. Yeah, it's made in Thailand.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
The company is called Propaganda, and it's really cool.
Oh. My mouth seems boring now.
แก้วน้ำ ชื่อยี่ห้อ Propaganda.
Propaganda นะคร
ับ แปลว่าโฆษณาชวนเชื่อ
ชวนเชื่อ
เลยต้องเอียง
ต้องเอียงนะครับ
คือนะ BYO mug hashtag โอเคผมก็มีเหมือนเดิมนะครับ voice 21นะฮะ smart voice นะฮะ
Yeah, feel free to send us new mugs since you know we're supposed to be bringing in new mugs.
And Kun Sueching, you still have the old stuff.
Yes, yeah, Instagram.
Okay, what we need to do is Sueching, you have to go to Apple's headquarters now.
Oh yeah.
And get us an Apple mug and an Apple Watch.
And an Apple Watch, please.
I would do that.
Thank you.
Okay, something very trendy in the basketball world. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a web now. It's a YouTube channel web called Dunkonomics.
Dunkonomics.
Okay, so you know, people think that only great dunks from dunks, you know, when people push the basketball through the hoop, come from great basketball players, you know, like Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, LeBron James. Not necessarily, because there's a whole generation out there of young basketball players with the abilities to jump really high, and they're not famous players. Mm. They are at high school levels, and they have these clips that shows their ability. I had the opportunity to look at this has gone viral. This is of a kid named Shelby McEwen. I use the term kid because he's in high school. Mm-hmm. Just let's show you this dunk.
Okay.
And see what you think. So John, man, that's free throw line.
No,
that's a left-hander in high school, and he's not well known yet. And you know, some of these guys make it to the NBA, some of them don't. But if you're interested in looking more of this, you know, which I've been, you know, looking at this, go to YouTube or go to Google and type in Dunkonomics.
But this Shelby kid is going to have a bright future.
No, that's what you think. But there are a lot of dunkers at high school levels that are really good. But then they don't end up getting to the NBA. Mm. It's not just the ability to jump and the talent alone that allows you to make it. So, but he has potential. Make no doubt about it.
Okay, ไปดูคอมเมนต์กันบ้างดีกว่าค่ะ คอมเมนต์จาก you made it to the cover.
Wow.
Keep calm.
Like
the United Kingdom will end as we know it.
Yes, but carry on anyway.
ขอโทษครับ ท่านทูตอังกฤษ Keep calm, Scotland is leaving you.
I know, it's very sad. Try not to cry and carry on.
คุณเพิ่งก็บอกว่าไป you are your dad.
มันเรื่องใหญ่นะอยู่ดีเสียดินแดนเนี่ย okay. okay. ขอบคุณรายการมากเลยนะให้ทั้งความรู้ด้านภาษาอังกฤษและความรู้ในเรื่องต่างๆมากมาย
คุณเอนิภาพันธ
์ค่ะกำลังพยายามเรียนรู้ภาษาอังกฤษจากการดูรายการ Talking Thailand
Thank you very much and คุณโกะนันทนันว้าว
เป็น what... แฟนขาประจำของเราเลย
Yes what an interesting episode did not know about ISIS okayWell, you know the extremist group.
Sure.
Now will be hunted down by the armies of the United Kingdom and the United States.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. I know.
Big time.
Yeah.
Big time. แล้วก็ต้องขอบต้องแสดงความยินดี congratulate those who got the NOAA DVDs.
ค่ะ
We've got a lot of feedback on that. People mm-hmm. talk about where Kun Nim went to, you know, to Tibet mm-hmm. and all that. So also five lucky people. Changing time is not a problem. It's I think it's better than the daytime. I love it.
Good.
What is he talking about? What is
the new air time of Talking Thailand? Remember that we changed.
Okay.
From 11 to 9 now.
Okay, and hopefully we'll be on somewhere around 10 in the upcoming year.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And I love Talking Thailand. ขอบคุณครับ Tea Dream. พอเปลี่ยนช่องมาเจอรายการนี้แบบบังเอิญ
เห็นอาจารย์ดำค่ะก็เลยนั่งดูแล้วก็บอกว่าชอบมากๆค่ะว่าอาจารย์ดำสามารถเรียกแขกได
้ I have to be honest with you there are a lot of channels out there but content wise there's nothing that compares to this
yes I'm not gonna argue
ไม่มีอีกแล้วไม่มีอีกแล้ว this is it ดีใจจังเลยมาเร็วขึ้นนิดหน่อยทุกวันเสาร์นะฮ
ะ
all right andคุณนัทธิกา
อ๋อค่ะที่ครั้งที่แล้วซูชิงพูดว่าได้มาเข้าร่วมใน Google Hangout Session ด้วยกันนะคะเขาก็เลยบอกว่าดีใจจังเลยที่จำได้ว่าเคยมา Hangout ด้วยกันแล้ว
And she comes to all of the events
Very
of Voice
TV Very loyal fan
as well.
of Voice TV. Thank you very much.
And that's all the comments for Talking Thailand. So hopefully the kingdom, the United Kingdom will stay in touch.
I really hope so. We'll have to see next episode.
Okay, and we have to find a way to get around to getting one of those Apple Watches here.
Yes, exactly.
แล้วก็ต้องขอบคุณคุณอาร์ตด้วยนะฮะ
ค่ะ
เจ้าของ Wellograph วันนี้มาเป็นแขกรับเชิญนะครับ we look forward to seeing him make it big in the US. Have a great night. This is Voice TV's Talking Thailand. วันนี้ลาไปก่อนครับสวัสดีครับ
สวัสดีค่ะ
สวัสดีครับ